What's up, geeks, and welcome to the channel. So, in this video, we are going to answer the famous abstract data types versus data structures question. And to tackle this subject more efficiently, we are going to start with a quick real-life example. Let's imagine we are at the cinema, and it is the release day of Avengers Endgame, so the number of people who want to book their seats is growing by the minute. This cinema in front of our very eyes is making millions of dollars. Yet no one, not a single person, is waiting for more than 5 minutes to pick up their tickets. Every person is being served by hand by a salesperson, and every customer is being welcomed by an usher. Isn't that fascinating? How can these few employees serve all the ongoing increase in the number of customers? To ease things a little, let's try and make a list of the tasks that can be accomplished by the salespersons and ushers from our point of view, like the menu, the list of things we expect them to do in order to help us, like book a seat for us, right? Serve us popcorn or a drink, show us our seats. But wait, how is this list of expectations going to help us answer the question about the increase in demand exactly? What are they doing exactly to adapt to the ongoing increase? Are they using an underlying super fast software to book the seats? An alien popcorn machine, maybe? Are they cloning themselves as more people come in? Well, the point is, why do we even care? If we have our popcorn, our drink, our tickets, and we're ready to go, if these employees provide us with what we expect them to provide us, the menu, right? Why should we care how they do it? The actions exhibited by the employees, this menu that we wrote together, is in fact a definition. The what we the users are expecting from these employees. The how, or how the employees are actually providing the users with their orders, is what we call the underlying implementation. You see, the manager can come in at any time and change this implementation, i.e. change how the tasks are being distributed among the employees, or anything else. But as long as the menu, the expectations from the user point of view, remains the same, we have no problem. If after the manager's intervention, or in case of a computer program, the developer's intervention, the user is no longer able to book a seat, for example, then yes, we have a problem, because the menu and the expectations have changed, aka the abstract data type has changed. So abstract data types are models, definitions, logical descriptions from the point of view of the user, where we define the operations we can perform on given data, and what is the expected behavior of these operations. Data structures, on the other hand, specify how these operations will exhibit these behaviors. They are the concrete implementations of the abstract data types. In object orientation, we can have a queue, a stack, or a list as abstract data types. The list abstract data type, for example, tells us that the menu, the allowed operations that can be performed, consists of the add, which will add an item to the list, the remove, which will remove an item from the list, and the get, which is going to return the value associated with a given index. But how are these operations being performed? Were they implemented using an array as underlying data structure, or maybe a linked list? From the information I have provided up till now, we can't possibly know. All we have is the abstract data type, the definition, the set of allowed operations we can perform if we choose to pick the list abstract data type and use it. But what we know for sure is that whatever we pick, whether the array or the linked list, all three of these operations will be available. If I choose to pick the array as my underlying implementation, and because of that choice, then the add operation will no longer be available. So, the array isn't an appropriate solution or implementation for this abstract data type. Let's take the queue abstract data type as another example. We know that the set of allowed operations will be to enqueue or dequeue an item in a first-in, first-out manner. But what is the underlying data structure used behind the enqueuing and dequeuing? That is up to the implementer to decide. All we care about is that upon calling the dequeue method, the item returned to us will be the item found on the top of the queue. And upon calling the inQueue method, the item will be enqueued in the back of the queue. Now, what about, let's say, trees? Some people refer to trees as abstract data types, others as data structures. Well, you can say that this confusion was created because the same word is used to represent both of them. And when there is such a confusion, when the same word is used to represent both the abstract data type and the data structure, then know that most of the time, this word actually represents the abstract data type. So in our example here, a tree is in fact an abstract data type. The tree abstract data type has a lot of implementations, and most of them will be covered here on Geekific in upcoming videos, so stay tuned. Okay, to sum up everything, abstract data types state what are the expected behaviors from a user point of view. They are the interfaces for a certain underlying implementation or data structure. These implementations state how these behaviors will actually be exhibited without affecting the desired expected outcome. So, that's it for this video. I hope it was helpful. Thank you guys for watching. Take care, and I will see you on the next one.